ਕਿਉਂ ਰੁੱਸ ਗਿਆ ਤੂੰ ਆ ਕੇ ਦੱਸ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਛੱਡਣਾ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਦੱਸ ਕੇ ਛੱਡ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਬਟ ਇਟ ਟਰੂ ਆਫ ਨੀਨਾ ਦੈਟ ਆਈ ਬੋਟ ਆਲ ਹਰ ਸਾਰੀ ਸ਼ੀ ਨੈਵਰ ਬੋਟ ਐਨੀ ਐਜ਼ ਫਾਰ ਐਜ਼ ਪ੍ਰੋਮਿਲਾ ਇਜ਼ ਕਨਸਰਨ ਸ਼ੀ ਹੈਜ਼ ਵੈਰੀ ਗੁੱਡ ਟੇਸਟ ਹਰਸੈਲਫ I have reason to believe that I have better taste. I'd love to buy a painting, but I wish Modi were to do one on Varanasi. I mean, if it's beautiful enough, I'd certainly buy it. And if it's a jumla, I won't.
You did your first Punjabi song recently. Tell me about that thought. Tell me about writing in Punjabi while you think in English.
Well, so, you know, I don't think in English anymore, but I really did not think I could write lyrics in Punjabi, but I managed to do that. Kyun rus gaya tu aake das mainu, chhadna hai te das ke chhad mainu. Some of my lyrics in Punjabi have been sung by Adnan.
Okay.
So that's part of my private collection.
But yes, course, Adnan Sami and A.R. Rahman.
Rahman I've launched an album with. When I was gave my lyrics to A.R. Rahman and I gave him a compilation of what I had written. He just chose about 5-7 of them. And he would come to Delhi and sit with me and he would then sort of understand my thoughts and then he would compose the music. And it was a fabulous experience. He's a genius.
To quote you, how many times has falling in love and parting happened?
It's happened twice. Once parting and twice in love.
Okay.
Once with Nina, my first wife, when I met her at 16 in college. It happened to be in a play where I was a Julius Caesar and she was Calpurnia. So that sort of relationship which started at that time lasted for many, many years till we were married. We started the relationship in 64 and we got married in 73. So we were together for 9 years. I had to part with her, not of my own will, but she passed away because of cancer in the year 2000. It was painful, but I'm happy that I was with her when that happened. And then, of course, my relationship with Promila, when I fell in love with her as well. She is a woman with great commitment towards me and towards what I stand for and what I do and my family.
Both the women, ladies in your life have never had to buy saris or jewelry because these are things you instinctively shop for and you have a better taste than both of
them. I don't know about that, but it's true of Nina that I bought all her saris. She never bought any. As far as Promila is concerned, she has very good taste herself. But I have reason to believe that I have better taste. I've been actually collecting paintings for the last 30, 40 years.
Collecting? Buying?
Buying mostly, but also friends, for example, Hussein. MF was my client and became a very close friend. Actually, it's very interesting. He did a portrait of me.
Okay.
And he did it with his hands. And he came to me one day on my birthday. He just landed up and said, I'll do a portrait for you.
Which means you've always been rich.
What does being rich mean? People who cannot spend are poor. So I'm rich in that sense. That I don't worry about spending money.
Because you have it.
No, lots of people have it and don't spend it.
Two people have been responsible for your entry into politics. Narasimha Rao and Lalu Yadav. So tell me about both.
Narasimha Rao for entry into politics, Lalu Yadav for entry into parliament. Narasimha Rao ji rang me up in 1996 before the Lok Sabha elections and said I should stand from South Delhi. And I think part of the reason was that in 1993 I represented Ramaswamy and defended him in parliament. And I told him I was going to lose because Sushma Swaraj was on the other side. There's no way I could have won. She is a stalwart in her own right. So basically, I was facing defeat and I accepted defeat before I started. But I fought the election. And of course, then in 1998, I was doing, of course, Lalu's case. And the Rajya Sabha elections came about. And Congress didn't have enough numbers to send their own nominee. Kesriji supported. He was then the president of the Congress party. And I went to Mrs. Gandhi and I said, look, this is what Lalu has said. He said, great, because we cannot get a nominee in. So that's how I got into parliament. I am ideologically a little left of center.
And yet you're the most expensive lawyer, where the underprivileged can probably not even reach your outreach.
Well, that's not true at all. In fact, I have represented, I don't charge at all for those who cannot pay, cannot afford to pay, and who have a genuine cause which I think should be defended.
You have a great collection of paintings from Varanasi, on Varanasi and from Varanasi. After Mr. Modi became Prime Minister, did you stop buying them?
No. I'd love to buy a painting, but I wish Modi were to do one on Varanasi.
If you would buy one?
Yes, I mean, if it's beautiful enough, I'd certainly buy it. If it's a jumla, I won't.